In 2011, Video Volunteers worked on a video project with an environmental group known as the Indian Network of Ethics and Climate Change. We have been training community correspondents from marginalized backgrounds to report on issues in their own communities. Similarly, through these CCs, we hope to look at climate change from a local perspective. As a result, what we have is 18 3-minute videos from across 14 states. This is what communities have to say about climate change.
साल पहले जो बारिश होता था समय समय पर होता था, और अभी जो बारिश हो रहा है सो समय पर नहीं हो रहा, इसके कारण से अच्छी तरह से फसल नहीं हो रहा है।
टेम्परेचर अचानक हाई, अचानक डाउन, यम सत्य कि ये प्रोडक्ट सही चुन पत रोजान
कीगा मो कम कम हाथ 8 बोरी 10 बोरी मक्का निकलता, आज 2 बोरी मक्का 1 बीघा मो नहीं निकलता।
தொழில் நாங்கள் போடுற தொழில் வந்து கடல் தொழில், அவங்க மீன் பிடிச்சினா வந்து நாங்கள் மீன் வாங்கி போய் வியாபாரம் பண்ணுறோம். அப்போலாம் வந்து மழை காத்துனா இந்த மாதத்தில் தான் வரும், இந்த மாதத்துல தான் போகும்னு தெரியும். அந்த மீன கடைங்களாம் இது இங்கே ஒன்றும் இல்லைன்னு சொன்னால் ஆம்பளைக்கும் தொழில் இல்லை, பொம்பளை வியாபாரி எங்களுக்கும் எந்த அவங்க பிடிச்சினா அது கொடுத்தா தான் நாங்கள் வியாபாரம் பண்ண முடியும்.
Previously, these fishermen and farmers know from passed on wisdom how to predict weather. When is a good time to plant seeds? How much rain will the crops get? How much sacks of grains will they be able to harvest? But weather patterns like monsoon and temperature are changing so quickly that their yield is coming lesser and lesser every year. And these are farmers with 1 acre of land and less. And they constitute 80% of the agrarian population. We saw how farmers are affected by climate change. So are people who depend on farm producers as raw materials. One such person is Jairam, a weaver from a part of India called Gujarat. He depends on cotton to make different types of fabrics, but is struggling day by day to cope with poor cotton harvests.
હવે અત્યારે અમારા ગામની અંદર તેથી 20-25 વર્ષ પહેલા 100 સાળું વણાટ કામ ચાલતો હતો, અત્યારે માત્ર હું એક જ વણાટ કામ કરું છું.
When harvest is down, crop prices go up. Like the weaver, these herders are finding it harder to afford hay for their cattle.
હું પશુપાલનનો ધંધો કરું. આમાં જે ટાઈમે વરસાદ થવો જોઈએ બરોબર, કે વરસાદ ન પડે પછી ઘાસચારો મોંઘો પડે, ઘાસ બહારથી લાવવું પડે, પછી બહુ વાતાવરણ સારું ન હોય એટલે માલ માંદો પડે, પશુપાલન ભૂખ્યા રહે.
We see that it's not just farmers and fishermen that are affected. So are industries which depend on agriculture as a raw material. Urban people have choices. If it's hot, they wear something light. If milk production is affected, they pay more for milk. If they don't get to drink fresh and sweet juice, they drink something else. But can the juice vendor switch jobs as easily? Amol, our CC from Bombay, speaks to a juice vendor that he frequents.
अभी बीच में देखो नवरात्रि के टाइम बारिश आ गया, उस टाइम गन्ना भी बढ़ने लगा था, लेकिन बारिश इतना ज़ोर से आ गया उसके साथ में हवा भी आ गई, तो हवा और बारिश इसके लिए वो गन्ना गिर गया. बस ऐसे जिधर से टेढ़ा होता है उसके बाद तो उसका मीठापन एकदम से कम हो जाता है, जो यहाँ से टेढ़ा हो गया तो यहाँ से पूरा मिठास कम हो गया, उसकी वजह से हमारे ग्राहक के ऊपर भी परिणाम हो जाते हैं. मीठा नहीं लगेगा तो कोई भी ग्राहक बोलेगा क्या है जूस दिया, पानी डाल के दिया है क्या.
Communities point the finger at large companies because they see how forests are cleared to build more factories. How these factories in turn release more fumes into the air.
इसमें जो मजदूर कंपनियां, सरकार कंपनियां ना बोल रही, प्रोत्साहन दिला असल्यामुळं कंपन्या उत्पन्न होत्या, त्याचं प्रदूषण झाल्यामुळं हवामानावरती परिणाम होतो, पाऊस पडत नाही
मोठ्या प्रमाणात, तो धूरबीर बाहेर सरपातो जाऊन होते ॲसिड हे जातो.
The irony is that these industries are the ones contributing the most to climate change, but they don't pay the price. Who pays the price? The 80% of Indians who survive off what they can earn from their 1 acre of land.
आकार की वजह से हमारे टाइम तो किसान हम लोग आ गए इधर मुंबई में.
When these people talk about how climate change forces them to give up livelihoods, it is about giving up traditional, self-sufficient occupations passed on from many generations and to start from scratch in urban slums. Others who can't migrate die hungry.
Are policymakers listening to people on the ground? Do communities participate in drafting these policies that have direct impact on them? At Video Volunteers, our work becomes important in this regard. We are trying to push community voices into policy procedures. Without listening to people's voices and wisdom, we will not have policies that respond to people's needs.
Now that you have watched these videos, please show the world that climate change is already affecting communities in a big way. Forward this video to at least one environmental NGO you know and on your Facebook and spread this message. Bring community voices to where they belong, in the center stage of the discussion on climate change.